Rabbi Kaplan, part two.
So the youngsters heard the message from Reb Chaim Zimmerman, and then came the Talmidim, and they heard the message, and they never knew him, that Shelo Yodas Yosef, they didn't hear of him, didn't know of him. And the message that went over was the Tachlis's brilliance. I remember when I was a young boy, to me, mistaken, naive, pure boy.
From Baltimore,
and,
even.
And this was, it was said to me that your tachlis is to say Torah. You have to be able to say. And I didn't understand, but I learned the Gemara. I know the Gemara. What do I say now? I finished learning the Gemara. What am I going to say? And that caused confusion and confusion, what you call in Ivrit Tisbuch, for years and years and years, and had an influence on all kinds of other things. All because that the message wasn't explained to me the right way, and I didn't understand it. And I wasn't that brilliant in those days, although, with the not being brilliant, I learned through the whole Chulin before the Bar Mitzvah. Without doses, I learned it through. I still remember it from then. I learned Kalim and all those in a very young age. I learned other Masechtas at a young age. I didn't know there was anything special about that. I took the Gemara and I learned it. What's so hard about that? But what else am I supposed to do? What are the Magidish here trying to tell me? What are they trying to teach me? I'm supposed to do something. I'm supposed to learn something from them. And what am I supposed to do? I didn't know. So how do I do it? They know how to do it, but how do I know how to do it? Of course, these youngsters that they learn by the yeshiva and the name of Reb Chaim Zimmerman, they all know. They're not like that. They're not these naive Tamimas Deka boys. They know how to go deep and how to ask and how to answer. And by the way, I once met a bocher from that group by a chasna. It was the chasna of my nephew, Avram Stub, that he also learned there. Or sat there, whatever he did there.
Well, your boy Sfeliezer learned there, no?
No.
No, I'm mixing up.
And he, and this bocher said, I'm asking him, like,
but my Nachman learned there.
What's your yeshiva about? And he told me, well, we learn Rav Baruch Ber, we learn Rav Chaim. Yeah, our yeshiva learns Rav Baruch Ber, we learn Rav Chaim. And we don't learn Rav Shimon Shkop and Rav Ochoran Wasserman, no. Why? Because Rav Baruch Ber is Yosher and it's this and it's that. Now, there is a difference between Rav Baruch Ber and Rav Chaim and Rav Shimon and Rav Ochoran. But it's roy for every ben Torah to learn Reb Shimon and Reb Ochoran. And then think on your own. What do you think about it? You're allowed to think on your own. But there's so much you could get out of this for many ideas. In fact, the Reb Ochoran was written very, very big kids. And the Kavitzars, he wrote a little bit longer. But there's the basic raid in all the sugyas. You see over there. Of course, Reb Ochoran is maybe a higher level. I'm not going to use the word a different level because somebody doesn't understand what that means. I'm emphasizing a higher level. So maybe it is a higher level of Torah, but there's a lot you can get from Reb Ochoran and Reb Shimon. And another thing, to say that to you, to Bochrim, 17, 18-year-old, Bale Gaive, that the basis that they started with is that the purpose of Torah is to reach Gaiva, and to go tell them that, the message that you're giving them is, we are big enough to be mezalzel in Gedolei Olam. We are big enough, we're smart enough, because we talked ourselves in that we're geniuses. That's what it's saying. That's what they hear. You don't always go according to the words. Not everybody did. I know a certain person, everything he takes literally. He just knows the words that he heard. He can't read between the lines. But a lot of people can read between the lines. And what they hear when you tell them that, we don't learn Rav Shimon and Rav Ochoran. What do they hear? We're geniuses. We're big. We all we have to do is connect ourselves to the group that belongs to Abraham Zimmerman, and we become geniuses. Just like those that connect themselves to Rav Nachman Breslover are going to be saved from Gehenna with that. And the Balei Tshuva that don't understand takes that to mean that you don't have to be Homo Bat Torah. You just connect yourself to Rav Nachman Breslover and you'll have salvation. It doesn't go that way. That's not how Yiddishkeit is. And that's what these youngsters think. When came a while later, a few years later, I saw the same bacha walking in the street with a girl with a short skirt, a tefach above the knee, and he's walking with her and talking seriously. Rachmana Litzlan, that the Pshira and Rabbachon are not good enough for you, and a cave that looks like a zona is good enough for you. Rachmana Litzlan, where did you learn that? Who taught you that? I have a chash that indirectly, in an indirect way, it was picked up from the Talmidei home. And what do you think? He's in Olam Shekulo Tov now. But he has charot of what he caused, what he taught, the message that he gave over, and what the Talmidei, and how they came out. And I know a maisa of a bacher that's really as my son told me, that he went to that yeshiva, and he asked a certain person there, why is it that when you finish Munetzah, you don't go three steps backward? And the bacher was a stickler. He had an azus. The first day he was there, he went up and asked. I mean, I would never have the guts to do that, but I think the bacher did good. Why don't you go three steps back? And he just was mizalzel, he was tochim. No, this is a halacha. This is a omet lifnei hamelech. Shmonesri is a omet lifnei hamelech. You have to walk three steps back. It's a derech kovod when you part from the standing in front of the king. How can you be mizalzel in such a thing? At least say, you're right, I made a mistake. And the question is, can you? Well, this is the old question that we always have been asking. Can you judge a person or a place according to one or two stories? Maybe I'm wrong. Maybe I'm saying wrong. Maybe the place is full of Yiras Shamayim. Maybe they learn Musar half an hour a day. Maybe they're all careful from Lashon Hara. Maybe they all think about the Shivisi Hashem L'Negdi Talmid most of the day. Maybe they daven B'Kavona and remember their Omid Lifnei HaMelech. Maybe I'm all wrong. And all these things were just a mikru. It could also be. But I see that it fits. It fits with a certain pattern. I knew Rav Chaim Zimmerman, and all this, it's fitting that this should be the Talmidei Talmideon of it. The Taklis of Torah might be something else altogether. Chazal say, the Gemara in the end of Perekah Nechnokim in Sanhedrin, Shochu Mitom, they sent a message from Eretz Yisrael. They sent a message to Bovil. In those days, sending a message was hard. It was something that took days and weeks to send a message. We nowadays press a button and the message is over there in the sofa. You can imagine if they gave a message for the people that are going from Eretz Yisrael to Bava, must have been Dvarim Amdim Berumu Shalolam, one of the most important things a Yid has to know. What was the message they sent? A Zeu Ben Olam Abba. Who's a Ben Olam Abba? It's important. It's not just to know how do you get schar, how do you sit in the Mizrach of the Mesifta Derakia. That's not the whole purpose of it. There's a Ben Olam. Olam Haba. He walks around in this world, but he's a ben, a son of Olam Haba. He's living in Olam Haba, even though he's in this world. The Avir of Gan Eden surrounds him. The Matzav of Olam Haba is what he's in. The Olam has his small to him. He's a ben Olam Haba. His mind is in a different place. Who is it? Does it say he could say brilliant Torah? Does it say that he knows Shas? Does he say that he knows how to talk against all the Gedolim that are nowadays in the door before? No. Exil ben Olam Haba Anvason, Onov, Shfal Berech. He goes low. Shaif Ayil, Shaif Nofik. He bends down when he comes in. He doesn't come in and make an impression. I'm here. I that learn Rabbah Ben Rab Chaim, I'm here. Shaif Nofik, after the Seder, he finished the Seder of learning. He's going out of the Beis Medrash. He was Mechadish Chidushim while he was there. He probably did say brilliant Torah while he was there. He knows. It's all Hashem gave me this seichel and Hashem put it into my mind. I made a yigir. The mail I was zocher that Hashem let my mind open up and he gave me this chidushim. So when he goes out, shayif nofik. He bends out down when he goes out. And then it says, vikoris baraisa tadira. It doesn't say he's mechadish chidushim tadira. He's goris Torah all the time. He learns and learns. He just reads a lot of Gemaras. It doesn't say he understands. He doesn't understand. If he can't learn, so he reads, he says. But he uses up his time. That already is hard to understand. He's after being an onov and a shfal berach and a shayif ayil, shayif nofik. What else could you ask from the person? It's not machzik tova for himself. He doesn't think magili, I deserve. It's a madrega is one is more delicate than the other one. One is deeper than the other one. The whole could be that those that are go b'shiflus, those that go b'anivis, it could be in the next world they're going to sit up high up. And those that said brilliant Torah and they showed gaiva, they're going to be sitting in the back. And I don't know, the Gemara says in Shabbos that Shmuel, Rav Yehuda, was sitting in front of his Rebbe Shmuel. And a woman came dining on that day that people that stole things from her, did avlist or whatever. So he said, she came screaming that avlist were done against her. So Shmuel didn't listen. He just kept learning. So Rav Yehuda said, Leslay Lamar, Otim Osno Mizakas Do. It's a terrible thing to close up your ears from the screaming of a poor person. So he answers him, look, we have a Rosh Bezdin in Marukva, we have a dying in the city. It's on his head, he's supposed to take care of these things. And you think Shmuel didn't have Rachmanis. Of course he had Rachmanis. And you think Shmuel was sitting there wasting his time, Chas Hashem. Yet, the Gemara says in Baba Basra, that when there was somebody that he went, his neshama went up to heaven and he saw the Masifta Derekia. And then he came back, his father asked him, what did you see up there? He said, El Yonim Lamata V'tachtonim Lemalo. And there's a pshat there brought in Tarshish the Rav Yudah, and Shmuel's the Talmud and Rav Yudah's the Rebbe. Why? Because of that one mice that he said a Ha'or on his Rebbe, Otem Ozno Mizak Hasdo, why don't you listen? The Rav Rachmanis and the poor person screaming. But Shmuel was the Rebbe of Rav Yehuda. That means that we have no mussag of the greatness of Torah of these people. Not of Rav Yehuda, not of Shmuel. And if he was on the level of being his Rebbe, he was much greater than him. Yet because of a certain midah of Rachmanis, a certain pig. again, stuck in a dock, I didn't leave deck. That Shmuel had to change the Rebbe, and he sits by in front of Rebbe, and Rebbe becomes the Rebbe.
Rav Kaplan, we have to take a break now.